Hello everyone, welcome to My English, My Life, an online program to learn English classes from class 6 to class 12. Today we are going to discuss our 10th class, great theme that is biodiversity. From that we are going to talk about this interview with a Nobel Prize winner, and she's a woman who fought for the environment, who we call as a woman loves environment. So here we have an interview with the environment fighter who fought for the freedom, who fought for the rights, and who encouraged many people to make the environment clean and green with her works. So for that notable work, she was awarded Nobel Prize. Today we have a lesson that is environment. So let me put a question in front of you before getting to the interview. So here, what is the meaning of environment? We have two pictures here. You can see the pictures there. And in the first picture, if you look at the first picture, we can feel that it was too devastated, or it was too polluted, and it was too damaged. If you look at the second picture, there we can feel a good atmosphere and a green place and nice houses, everything we can feel. So what is the difference between the first picture and second picture? Maybe we can find that first was fully polluted and second one is pollution free. Same thing here, biodiversity, in that we have environment means we have the primary right to take care of our environment. In our 9th class we studied the lesson, what is man without trees? So that was also one of the best lesson about environment. So here, a woman who fought for the environment, to save forests and to help the people to go for afforestation, to planting trees. So in our Telangana or in Andhra Pradesh, the chief minister started a program. We know that very well. In Andhra Pradesh recently, they started a Vanna Mahotsav, the 71st Vanna Mahotsav, to plant nearly 20 crores of trees or plants around the state of Andhra Pradesh. And in Telangana also, we know very well. And we have a machine name to plant all over the trees. So it was very, very familiar. Why all the people were concentrating? Why all the governments are taking care of the environment means, if you spoil the environment, it will give back for us. If you make it clean, it will be very clean. If you spoil it, it will spoil us. So clearly she mentioned about all those things, how she fought against the people who are going for deforestation, how she made a forest, and how she encouraged. Let us read by the interview. Let's begin the class. Interview with Wangari Maathai, environmental activist and Nobel Prize winner. Wangari Maathai started the Green Belt movement and also fought for equal rights for women in Africa. She is the first African woman to win Nobel Prize, Peace Prize. Read the excerpts from her interview with Nippon Hoso Koikai, Radio Japan. So now here is a speech for us by first woman to receive Nobel Peace Prize from Africa, that is Wangari Maathai, and she was awarded for the work, and she is an environmental activist, mean to save environment. She was fighting for the save environment. So here a speech for us, some points which was interviewed by the radio people. So here we have the speech. Let's read and understand. How did you become aware of the environment? From the time we started, we were trying to respond to the basic needs of people in rural areas. People were asking for clean drinking water, for food, for energy, for building material, for food or for the animals. All these come from the land. So we knew that what people are in the rural areas were asking for that, for had to do with the environment. They did not have those things because the environment was degraded. So from the very beginning, we understood that we have to rehabilitate the environment. So here the first question asked by the interviewer, that is that how you got awareness, how you got the idea to take care of the environment, how you became, what made you to become an environmental activist. So the further that question, clearly she given answer. So when we go to rural areas, village areas, there you can guess the question, that is they will survive with the help of environment, means from the land, for example, for food, for water, and for the food for animals, for building materials, means for building houses they need wood. So everything is related to environment. That means everything is related to land, the place where they were living, the forest. So everything was related to that. So whatever they are using, whatever they are getting, whatever they want, that is related to environment and that is related to land. But nowadays they were not getting that. They are not getting food for animals. They are not getting any proper drinking water through the rivers. At the same time, they were not getting wood or the timber to construct homes. That they were not getting anything because it was degraded. So we, the people of environmental activists, I try to rehabilitate, means I want to reconstruct, I want to rehabilitate, means till now they lost everything. So I want to again regenerate all those things, what they want and what they lost. So that was the answer given by Vangihaji Mathai for the question, how she got aware on environment. The forested mountains were the source of water and the source of rain. So when you deforest, you cause a shortage of water and a change of rainfall patterns, and therefore people are not able to get food and water. Therefore, in order for them to have good environment that can sustain their livelihoods, it is important to have a government that accounts to them, that protects them, that protects their interests, that is concerned about their life. So the primary things, we know that food, shelter and clothes, we know that. So food they are getting from forest, water they are getting from the mountains. So if you deforest, if you choke down the trees, if you make deforest, what will happen? Proper improper rainfalls. For that one, we are getting improper rainfalls. Most probably we know in the middle of the month, for example March, we will get rains. In the month of May, we will get rains. So during summer sometimes we will get rains, during winters. Why this improper rainfall? Means there was no proper environment. When we deforest, we will lose the trees. We have more trees, we have mountains, with that help we can get more rainfalls. If you deforest, if you chop down the trees, we will lose rains. If there is no rainfall, there will be no water. So that is a problem for the people. They are not getting water because they are in the deforest. Means most of the people, some people came and they are deforest and they are giving some other opportunity and they are saying something to make a and they are chopping down the forest and they are constructing commercial plants, something they were doing. So that was a problem. Why happened? The people have to protect and the government should protect, and they have to make a system regarding this deforestation, regarding this saving the environment, saving the forest, saving the mountain. So the government should take a proper steps to take care of all of this forest and afforestation, deforestation. How is peace connected to a good government environment? Many wars that are fought in the world are fought over natural resources. So some wars are fought because the environment is so degraded that it is not able to support communities, and so they fight over little that is left. Others are fought because some people want to take a lot of the resources to control them and to keep many other people out. So previously we have seen many wars fighting for the natural resources. And we clearly can see, especially in African countries, many countries, many many states, many countries, in our African continent. If you observe clearly, Somalia, Romania, all these countries, they fought for the natural resources, means for water and for the mines. So they are fighting each other to get their natural resources. Nowadays, what happened? It become very quite natural for all the countries to degrade other countries' natural resources. So this is a major problem for war. So how peace is related to environment means the natural resources. If you save the natural resources, if you make all the people to get equal natural resources, there will be no war. But here, some people were dominating and they are occupying the lands, and others are making them as their slaves and they are ruling them. So it became a big problem to go for wars. So there we have a big disturbance of no violence, and it makes to go for wars. So that is the connection between war and environment. If you have equal rights towards the environment, then there will be no wars. Nowadays, they're having an upper and down, lower. Some countries are dominating other countries. For on basing of that, many people are getting together to fight against other countries to get a natural resources. That is the relation between the war and peace in related to environment. A good explanation was given by Wangari Maathai. Now, whether this happens at all national level or at the regional level or even at the global level, sooner or later there is discontent, and when that discontent is strong enough, there is conflict. And so good management of natural resources, equitable distribution of other these resources is important for peace. At the same time, good management of the natural resources is not possible if you do not have democratic space, respect for human beings, respect for human rights, giving other people dignity. So here, she was mentioning that it is not only happens in my place, it has to be spread all over the globally, from one place to another place. It has to reach, then only the people will know about the environment, and the people and the government should know the importance of environment and the natural resources. Not sooner or later, now or later, but one day they have to know and they have to implement all those things. If they have these disturbances in their countries, then very sooner or later there will be a big chance for conflicts, for fights and for the wars. So we should need a good democratic people or democratic countries and democratic ruling to get aware of these people and to get awareness on environment to create the development of human rights and for the support of human race and for the living beings, and at the same time for the livelihood of the trees and mountains and rivers and water, other natural resources. It should be by only good government. That is why the three themes are related, like African stool. With three legs and the basin on which you sit, the three legs, one leg is peace and other leg is governance, good governance, and the third leg is sustainable management of resources. When you have those three legs, now you can put the basin, which is development. And if you try to balance that stool without those three, it won't happen. We have not shared our resources equitably. We have allowed some people, especially those in power, to acquire a lot of at the expense of the majority. And we have also engaged in conflict. So here, our Wangari Maathai was giving clear explanation about that is, when it is possible, and she mentioned three stool of an African state which can develop. For example, you take three leg stool here. One is a good governance, and second one we can see that first one is a peace. First leg is peace. Second one is a good governance. And third leg is sustainable natural resources. Sustainable of resources. So when we have three legs tool, when we have all these three, then we can make a development to sit on it. Or else it is not at all possible. It is not at all possible. So we have to share all our resources equitably. Means, for example, we have a 10 people house here and 5 people house here. Here 10 and here 5. So how much they need, 10 people has to take, and how much they need, the 5 people has to take. But here what happened? They are taking equally as 10 people. So there became a big conflict. So that was the problem, and that made the people and that made the countries to fight for these natural resources. So how much we need, we have to take. For example, if you have more people here, they will take, majority people will take more. Who are the minors, they will take less. But nowadays, what is happening on basing of the power, they are getting more equally with the higher people, means majority. So that made a big conflict. It made for to leads to war. So that was a big problem that made to go for conflict. So that was the answer given to the interviewer by Wangari Maathai. What was the environment like you when you were young, and how did you go about saving it? When I was a child, which is almost more than 50 years ago, the environment was very pristine, very beautiful and very green. We were a British colony, and the British government at that time started to clear the cut the indigenous forest in our forest mountains, because they wanted to establish commercial plantation of exotic species of trees such as the pines from the northern hemisphere and the eucalyptus from Australia. These trees are very, very nice. They grow tall and they grow very fast, but as they grow, they destroy all the local biological diversity and the flora and fauna disappear. So although we were getting commercial timber for growing timber industry, we also destroyed our local flora and fauna. So here the question, one more thing, is how you feel when you are young, how the environment, and now we are old, how the environment. So what are the changes you have been observed here? So she said, almost 50 years ago, I lived in a British colony, means the white people. So they came to our place and they started a forestation, means they are chopping down the forest, and they said they are going to plant commercial plants. So we have, when I was young, when I was a child, the environment was very, very pure and clear and beautiful, but now it has been changed. All the commercial plantation has been started. The local, the British colony, what happened? The British people has been, government has been chopped down all the natural trees which was in the forest, and they started commercial plantings. That is eucalyptus and pine trees. So they will grow up very, very fast. As they grow up, they will damage the local biodiversity. Means what happened? For example, the eucalyptus trees, they will grow very fast. And in a short time, they will grow very high and tall and very good strength. But when they grew up, the surrounding land will lose the fertility. Because of that, it will take the pine trees or the eucalyptus will take all the other lands, grounds, biodiversity, and it will grow very, very fast. So later, there will be no possibility of any other crops on the land. So that government was doing... the government was starting commercial plantings, and they growing for pine trees and local. They are damaging the local flora and fauna. So means the greatness, the beautiness of a forest. So that happened. So when they started commercial plantings, then we lose the natural resources of rainfall, and we lost everything because they started removing the natural and they started artificial. As a result, these forests, which were the water towers, were no longer able to contain the water. So when the rains fell in the water, ran downstream and end up in the lakes and oceans instead of growing down into the underground reservoir so that it could come back to us in the form of rivers. One thing we noted is that not only did the rain patterns change, became less, but also the rivers started drying up. We lost our local biological diversity, so that's a lot of damage to our environment. That is why in 1975, at the first United Nations Conference for Women in Mexico, many of the women were saying, we need food, we need water, we need clean drinking water, we need food for our animals. And I was wondering what was happening. These are things that were 20 years ago when I was a child. The environment had changed, and that's when I started this campaign to restore the vegetation and to the restore the land and the rehabilitate the forest. So here, Wangari Maathai, another point she concentrated that because of this planting of commercial trees, we lost the local fauna, flora and fauna, and the water, previously we have saved the water is going to underground. Now it was going through, directly going through oceans, and it was going towards the oceans, and they were drying up. So there was no place for storing water here. There is no chance to go underground with water and to give a good strength for trees and the forest. But why? Because they already constructed reservoirs, there is no storage of water, so it was going on. So there was no chance to stay in the forest, there was no chance to go underground. So that became that changed the local pattern of rainfall. Not only the pattern of rainfall, it changed the total livelihood of in the rural areas. In the 1975, there was a meeting held for in United Nations Organization for Women. At the time, most of the women were asked for food. We need food, we need water, we need pure drinking water, we need food for our animals. So why? Because they lost, there was no food for animals. They started eucalyptus, they started pine trees. So because of the commercial plants, it was not possible for eating. All the food, all the animals, they won't eat eucalyptus, they won't eat pine trees leaves. So they need the forest. They have to save the forest. In the same time, they have to get proper water, they have to get pure water, they have to get food for animals, they have to get timber for the development. Even with the commercial plants, they are getting timber, but they are losing the local flora and fauna, the beautiness of local forest, because of these commercial plantings which was started by British government in that place, not only in that place, everywhere it's happening, because in the name of commercial plants, in the name of development, in the name of getting more income, they are spoiling the local, the beautiness of forests. So that was happening there. So that was a clear point she mentioned. We have to save it, not only in Africa, in India, all of the places, our village, in our own village, in my own village. I have seen, previously we have big forest here, but it was a deforest and they started eucalyptus plants and they started pine trees because they won't get more money. The government itself started because to get more profit. So where is a good governance? Here there is no good governance. Three stool system. One is peace. We have to maintain peace. And another is maintaining good governance. And third one is maintaining natural resources. First one is maybe possible. Second, third, it is not yet possible in our India because the government itself, not state or central, the government itself started making eucalyptus trees and making the forest, and they're chopping down the forest and they started these pine trees and eucalyptus trees in the name of getting profit for the government. But they forget that they lose the local flora and fauna, the beautiness of the forest, and irrespective of our unseasoned rain and the changing of rainfalls, they are not pointing all those things, but they are getting only money. So that became big problem in our India. So it is happening in India. We have to know. If you have doubts, anything, you can go for checking in Google. We can find all the government, central government has been started this program long back. So this is the reason for we are getting unseasoned rains in our country. So this is the end of our today's class. Tomorrow we'll meet in the second part. Thank you. Have a great day. Who are watching, don't forget to subscribe and share to your friends. Have a great day. Meet in the next class. Bye-bye.